Going back to Brian, how is Brian?
Brian's very well, thanks for asking. He's back to 100%. He's doing his drawings. I mean, Brian's a very close personal friend, and has been since he came on the show. He's just a lovely, lovely guy. And this is the sort of thing about psychics is that it's very rarely I've met a psychic without an ego that's not bigger than their own alleged talent. And to be fair, if you call yourself a doctor, you have to prove you're a doctor by knowledge. It seems that anyone can call themselves a medium, take money off of people, not really, even legally, have to come up with anything that's plausible. I personally put out a challenge that's now, I think, 7 years old, of £250,000 for any one psychic to come and tell me one thing about my life that isn't out there.
Well, it was James Randi, wasn't it?
I put one out. James Randi is the one
you did. Yeah, he did one, and you've done one as well. Yeah.
But mine's a little bit more simple because it's just you have to tell me one thing. You don't have to go through any. There's no lab experiments. It's just one thing about my life that no one else can know. And if you do that, you get £250,000. And the strange thing is, which shows the selfishness of a lot of them, because the first thing they come up is, we don't do this for money. And you go, stop thinking of yourself. Just think if you've got that 250 grand, what charities you could give that to.
Exactly.
You know, what children's hospital could benefit from £250,000.
Exactly.
You know, it seems to always be about them. I'm not talking about everyone, and I don't want to upset.
I'm not upset
all the mediums out there, because I think there are real mediums out there.
Yeah.
I'm not sure either of them.
Yeah.
And I think one of the reasons we kind of step away slightly from the psychic part of involvement in most haunted is that if you're sat at a table and somebody who's psychic says, "Oh, there's an Elizabeth in this room," you're going on what they're saying.
Yeah.
And they could be completely wrong. They could be either making it up or just
very true.
Disillusion about what they're saying, and you could then start your investigation could go on to completely the wrong track.
Definitely, in
the fact that you could be asking for Elizabeth and there may not be one Elizabeth there, so your investigation is just going down a dead end.
Definitely.
And I think that's sometimes too many people follow a psychic down the road.
What do you think about, I mean, obviously the controversy is there are people out there that say most haunted, they fake it. How would you answer those people?
I love them, and we need them, because we caught controversy. That's what's really made the show officially the most successful paranormal show in television history. It's sold to over 97 countries around the world. We don't have any peers. There's no one that is even on the same level as what most haunted has achieved. So we've got lots of people copying us, and again, if flattery is the highest form, imitation is the highest form of flattery. We were completely flattered. But you need that controversy. When I was first asked by one of the broadcasters, it was Arch Dyson, who bought the show for UK Living, as it was then, he said, what do you want from this? And I said, I want a discussion. I want an argument. I want two people on a couch watching the show, one to say, I love it, one to say, what a load of shit.
Yeah.
Because they will go off and they will talk about it and conversations. And it did. It became one of the most controversial shows on television. It's easy for anyone to say it's faked. I mean, there's stuff on YouTube that's re-edited. People will take it off the television, they stick a voice in, they stick a bit of footage that they got off the most haunted and say that's fact. It's absolute crap.
It's like me, I've always said to people, I mean, were you there? Did you experience it?
What people don't realise is we're not allowed to. The huge thing about British broadcasting, and for I would say American broadcasting, is we are not allowed to fake anything. It's actually illegal for us to do so. If we do, we get fined, and so does the broadcaster, hugely. In America, it's encouraged. And I'm not saying that everything in America is fake. That's not what I'm saying at all. But what I'm saying is it's encouraged. There's something that they found that they were always looking for, strangely appears. It's often planted, but it's entertainment. It's the difference between factual entertainment and entertainment. And we are not allowed to fake it. If we did, we would have all been sued, and we certainly wouldn't have run for this amount of time. And to be honest, if we were going to fake it, do you honestly think we would do something really huge? I mean, we'd have had Henry VIII come and sit down and have a chat with us by now.
Exactly. Well, I'd like to thank you, Cara, for this. And, you know, I think if ever you're looking for a new member, the most common team, the Ghost Challenge is always available.
Well, I have to say, I really appreciate you coming out and sort of inviting me for this interview, because you know, everyone knows who you are, and it's been an honour to talk to you, so thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.